think 19th century was about the Industrial Revolution, about electricity, about disrupting the agricultural society and making it more advanced. The 20th century was about physics and engineering to do more things easier in our everyday life, from refrigerators to washing machines.
How convenient.
And the 21st century is definitely the digital age. It's the internet.
Even if you want to become a race car driver or play baseball build a house, all of these things have been turned upside down by software.
The LettuceBot is a robot that can sense its environment. Every single hour, this LettuceBot is seeing 1.5 million plants, and it's taking individual action on those plants. We enable lettuce growers to have higher yields in their field by helping make it cheaper, by helping produce food in a more sustainable way. And that wasn't previously possible without computer science and technology.
I have a really fun job where we build Polyvore, which kind of combines all my favorite things, so programming as well as fashion and art and design and shopping. Half the products you use these days are software products that you play with on maybe your phone. And so if you want to build something cool, you need to know programming, right? And there's so many things that you can do with computer science. So if you just work backwards from the cool thing that you want to build and figure out what that is, a lot of times computer programming is part of that, right? So you should learn the skill.
It's really exciting right now. The technology that we're developing right now is going to be used by your doctor in the next decade. When you come into the office and you're sick, the doctor is going to be like, all right, spit in this cup. And I will put it into this magic machine, which is a sequencer. And in an hour, I can tell you what you have or what's wrong with you. So if we're looking for a new virus, for example, we'll download a database of all the viruses that are known. And we'll search for, our sequence of interest against a whole database of all viruses. So you still need somebody to analyze the data. The computer is not smart enough yet.
Our software helps people save energy and thereby reduce their carbon emissions. To date, we've saved over 8 terawatt hours, which is the equivalent of about 1.1 million cars on the road.
When you're forecasting the wind, there's so many different parameters that go into it. It would be impossible for a human to sit down and do all those calculations. We need a computer model in order to forecast it.
Most people don't think about technology and public safety as going together, but our software is actually changing the way that law enforcement is capturing, transferring, and managing their digital evidence on a daily basis. It turns out that when officers are wearing our cameras, they see a drastic reduction in use of force, as well as a drastic reduction in the amount of complaints being leveraged against their agency, ultimately resulting in safer communities.
The merging of art and technology is getting more and more significant now. Because computers and software are such an integral part of our lives day to day, people are realizing that it can be quite creative to take this medium of computers and create incredible works of art.
In Finding Nemo, when Crush and Squirt and all the friends are flying through the East Australian Current, you're seeing images of water flowing by, you're seeing the colors on the back of the turtle, you're seeing the sides of the fish. All of those things are generated through math and computer programs that we write that we then give to the artist, and they take that to create that final image and tweak it and make it look beautiful and look fun.
The crux of it is really about invention. It's about looking at the world and being dissatisfied with things and questioning everything.
I always felt like if I didn't learn how to program, it would be like not learning how to read. The future would just be closed to me.
If you're in the coding profession, there's so many things that you can do, and you can pretty much pick and choose the course you want to be in.
I think that you can start something in your college dorm room, and you can have a set of people who haven't built a big company before come together and build something that a billion people use as part of their daily lives is just crazy to think about, right? It's humbling and it's amazing.
Really, it's about the chance to reinvent things and then see it out there in the world and see people using it and having fun or having a better life because of something that wasn't there before that you put in the world.